The baby was red in the face, screaming at the top of his lungs. I gently picked him up and rocked him back and forth.
Hush, little baby, don't cry. I'm here for you, I said.
Mom burst into the room. Ugh, you stupid girl. What's taking you so long to feed him? She said angrily. I jumped out of my seat when I saw how enraged her face looked. And get your finger out of there, Mom said.
My eyes teared up, and I tried to apologize.
But then Mom said, ugh, just go to your room.
But this is my room, I said.
Oh God, just leave, Mom yelled. You should understand being the oldest sister.
The next morning, while I was getting my twin brothers dressed for school and packing their bags, I could hear Mom and Dad screaming at each other in the kitchen. Well, that's how most mornings started around here. Very reluctantly, I walked into the kitchen because I had to prepare my brother's lunches.
Just stop complaining, woman! I'm sick of your constant whining and nagging. I'm doing the best I can! You do your part and let me have some peace for a change!
Dad was shouting.
I'm doing more than my fair share!
Mom screamed back.
I'm starting my second job today! What else am I supposed to do with all the brats I'm supposed to be taking care of?
Angrily, she turned towards me and said,
you can do more to take care of your brothers, Dana!
I wanted to say that I was already doing most of it, but I also felt sorry for Mom and wanted to help her, so I just nodded.
If she were a boy, she could have helped out so much more. Girls are just useless, Dad snapped.
I tried to hold back my tears, but a few rolled down my cheeks. Dad looked at me in complete disgust.
That's another reason I don't like girls. They are such crybabies.
Just then, my brother Zach, who was a year younger than me, walked into the kitchen. He saw my face and wrinkled up his nose, just like Dad.
Hey, dummy, are you making Mom and Dad fight again? You should just stay at home and help out with the chores, you know. It's not like you're any good at school.
Well, that was sort of true. Whenever I tried to read anything, I just couldn't make sense of the letters. Letters on a page jumped and danced all over the place when I looked at them. I just ignored Zach, put the twins' lunches in their bags, and started to head out the door to walk them to school. Just as I was leaving, I heard Zach bragging about the A+ he had gotten on his science project. Dad said that Zach was the only child who made him proud. School was the only time I ever had any fun. I was very popular. I was never asked to read aloud in class, and I wasn't even given any written assignments. When our exams came around, I was asked to give my tests orally in a private room with a special teacher. That's why everyone at school thought I was the daughter of some wealthy family, especially because I had just moved into town recently. This went on for 3 years, until Zach ruined everything, of course. One day, when I was hanging out with my friends at recess, Zach turned up at my school with my brothers.
Hey, dumbhead! You left this morning without getting your brothers dressed. Your mom is too busy being a janitor in another school to deal with all this. I'm not a babysitter. Stop wasting your time at school and take care of your brothers, idiot!
And with that, he walked off, leaving the twins behind. I was so humiliated as everyone stared at me in shocked silence. Now everyone knew I was no one special, just an idiot. I burst into tears, and my class teacher and the principal came out to see what was going on. They told me I could go home early today. I took my brother's hands and left. When I got home, I could hear Dad's voice coming from the lounge. I peeked in to see my dad talking to a creepy-looking, overweight woman I'd never seen before. Dad glared at me, and the woman looked up too as I walked in. She had strange, manic eyes that really scared me. I asked who she was, and she started scribbling something ferociously on a piece of paper and gave it to me. I tried to figure out what the note said, but the words were swimming in front of my eyes. I looked up at them, confused.
What's the matter with you, idiot? Can't you read?
Dad said in a frustrated voice. He said this was my Aunt Melanie, and she was his sister. She had been missing since she was a kid, and Dad had spent years looking for her. Dad said that she was going to live with us now, and she couldn't speak, so she was going to use notes to communicate. Oh, perfect. My mom didn't look happy at all to see this new sister out of the blue. That is, until she found out that my aunt was a good cook. One evening, when I'd cleared the table and was taking the dishes to the kitchen, I nearly screamed. The whole kitchen looked like it had been turned upside down. There was food everywhere, and it looked like my aunt had used every single bowl and dish we had. Mom peeked into the kitchen and said that she wanted everything spotless immediately. Then she went to sleep. Having my aunt around was a nightmare. She didn't help out with my brothers or the baby or any chores. All she did was cook and make a mess. It meant I had to do all the cleaning. She would stand by my side and wave notes in my face that I couldn't even read. She kept writing notes to my dad about how I was the stupidest kid in the family, which really made him roar with laughter. One day, I heard Mom yelling at Dad that my fat aunt was costing us too much money because she ate way too much and was cooking all the leftovers. We kept running out of food.
You have to ask her to leave, Mom said. I don't work two jobs for her to practice being a master chef.
Dad tried telling my aunt that she would have to find somewhere else to live. She looked at him with her crazy eyes, and then she totally lost it. She started making strange noises and throwing pots and pans in every direction. I ducked behind the counter to dodge a plate she had thrown like a frisbee. Dad tried to calm her down, but she just pushed him so hard that he almost fell on the floor.
You're crazy!
Dad shouted, his voice shaking.
I have enough insane women in my life. I don't need another one. Get out, now!
She threw her apron on the floor and walked out of the house.
Get up, you coward, and clean this
mess!
Dad snapped at me and walked off. The next day, we were all sitting in the living room when Mom walked in, looking really happy for a change. She said that she had great news for us. Dad didn't even look up and kept pretending to read his newspaper.
I'm pregnant! She said excitedly.
Dad jumped up from the couch like someone had given him an electric shock.
How did you let this happen? How was this good news?
Mom's good mood disappeared in an instant, and she started shouting at him that he was being ungrateful. A child was God's blessing. I just stared at the two of them, horrified. Just then, the bell rang, and a couple of cops walked in and straight up to Dad, saying he was under arrest. They said Aunt Mel had accused Dad of kidnapping her from the woman's hostel she used to live in, and because he knew she couldn't speak, he had made her a slave in his house. She said she was made to work day and night, and kept locked in a room without food and water for days if he wasn't pleased with her. She also said that she wasn't even related to him. Dad listened, in complete shock, and started arguing that none of it was true. But the cops dragged him off to the station. He tried to fight the case, but lost, and he was sentenced to several years in prison. With another baby on the way, and even less money than before, I decided I had to get a job while Mom could stay at home and take care of my brothers. I went to school in the morning and pulled double shifts as a waitress in a cafe in the evening. The next 3 years went by with me working my butt off to support the family, but we could barely make ends meet. I kept asking Zach to look for a job too, but he said a genius like him couldn't waste his time working and should only work on educating his brilliant mind. One day, Mom suddenly said, "Dana, since you were no good at school and won't go to college, I think you should get another job instead and help put Zach through college. We can only count on the smart one now to make our situation better." I stared at her, feeling like my head was about to explode. I'd had enough. Without a word, I took an empty suitcase from the closet and started throwing my things in. Mom kept asking me what I was doing, and I told her I was leaving. I was just done with this family. She looked like she was about to have a panic attack. She started crying and begging me to stay.
"I need you, Dana. How will I look after all the kids by myself?" she cried. "It's not my problem that you pop out a kid every year, Mom. You should have been more responsible. You're on your own now."
And with that, I was out of the house. I knew exactly where to go. My friend Rachel from the cafe was heading off to a little town by the sea, as she'd just accepted a job on a cruise ship. I talked to her, and Rachel helped me get a job as a housekeeper on the cruise ship. It was backbreaking work, but I felt happier and freer than ever before. At least this work didn't require any reading skills, and the other girls working on board were super fun. And we all quickly became friends. They were always telling me how pretty I was. No one had ever said that to me at home. Rachel was really wild and crazy, and even though the staff couldn't mingle with the guests, I would often catch her sneaking away and flirting with the cutest boys on deck. One day, she came in wearing an oversized, expensive blue sweater, and she said one of the boys had taken it off and given it to her because she was feeling chilly. The next day, she was sharing a box of chocolates another admirer had gifted to her.
"You should try being friends with one of the boys, Dana. The rich ones, of course. The others aren't worth the time."
She giggled as she stuffed her face with chocolate truffles. One evening, just as I had hit the bunk bed after a really long day at work, Rachel walked in dressed up in a gorgeous red gown. She was holding a deep blue one in her other hand, which she threw at me.
"Get up and get dressed. We're going to a party," she said, grinning.
I tried to tell her we weren't allowed, but she hushed me up by saying she'd been invited to the party by one of the boys, and she could bring a guest. Also, no one was going to recognize us out of our ugly uniforms. Well, that was probably true, I thought to myself as I stared at my reflection. I felt like a princess in the dress. As we entered the main hall, I looked around in awe. It was so grand, and it was full of very obviously wealthy people. Just then, a guy turned around and looked straight at me, and my stomach filled with butterflies. He was just so gorgeous. He smiled and walked over to me and said he would be happy to dance with me. I blushed as we joined hands and walked towards the dance floor. He told me that my blue dress matched the color of my beautiful eyes. Before the evening was over, we had fallen in love. It was a whirlwind romance after that. We couldn't stay away from each other and were always sneaking off to some part of the ship where no one would spot us. Late night moonlit walks on the deck, secret meetings during the day whenever I could manage to get away from work. It was the best few days of my life. One day, he had sneaked away from a dinner party to come to my room, and as we were kissing, the door suddenly burst open. It was Charles's mom. She looked at me with a disgusted expression.
"Charles, you chose this maid over Mary? Wait till your father finds out."
She turned around abruptly and left, with Charles running after her. I stood there in shock and anger, my legs shaking. I saw no sign of Charles for the next 2 days. I kept hoping he would come find me or at least send me a note. Nothing. Seeing how miserable I was, Rachel arranged for me to be one of the waitresses at a private party party his parents were hosting that night. That way, I'd at least get the chance to see him and maybe talk to him. As I entered the hall, my heart skipped a beat as I spotted him instantly at the dinner table with two gorgeous girls on each side. His dad rose from his chair at the head of the table and clinked his glass with a spoon to get everyone's attention.
Mr. Beaumont and I have been in business for a very long time now, and we have decided to make that connection even stronger by joining our two families. It is with great joy that I make this announcement. My son Charles is engaged to the beautiful young lady sitting next to him, Mary. They are to wed next month,
Charles's dad said. My heart stopped beating. I looked at Charles's face, and there was no sign of regret. He turned to Mary with a huge smile, took her hand, and kissed it as everyone cheered and clapped. Before I even realized what was happening, the tray of glasses in my hand had come crashing down to the floor, and everyone was staring at me.
You people with all your money, you're all so shallow and awful,
I screamed. Everyone just looked at me, stunned. Charles looked furious. His mother signaled a security guard to remove me from the room, and just as he was walking towards me, the whole ship shook, and we heard a loud cracking sound. Everyone in the room started screaming and running out of the hall in a panic. Soon enough, the captain started making announcements that the ship had hit an iceberg, and it was going to sink. People cried and screamed in horror all around me as they clung to one another. All the crew started to prepare for an evacuation. As I ran out of the hall, I heard someone call out my name. I knew that voice. It was one of my little brothers, and he was on the ship with the rest of my family, all except for Zach. Shocked to see them, I asked what they were doing here. They said Mom and the family had followed me when I left, and they had been on board all this time. Mom had hurt her leg and was in her room. I felt so scared that my whole family had followed me straight onto a sinking ship, leaving them with a steward. I rushed down to Mom's cabin. Mom! I hugged her tight. We have to get out of here. Let me help you up.
Where are we going to go?
Mom started crying.
Zach called your dad in prison and convinced him to sell the house to pay for his college tuition. Your dad was so angry with me that he agreed, and everything was in his name. We're homeless now.
I was furious hearing that, but I wasn't shocked at all that Zach would do something so selfish. We heard another loud sound, and I told Mom that we had to hurry and get out of here. Up on the deck, I could see that people had started to leave the ship on the small lifeboats. As I put life jackets on my brothers, I could see Charles screaming like a little girl as his boat was being lowered into the water. What a pathetic loser. As we sailed off into the cold, dark sea in the night, I looked over at my mom and little brothers. They all looked completely exhausted. I promised I would always take care of them. My brother tugged at my sleeve and said,
"That was awesome! We're on an adventure! And it's gonna be really fun, right?"
I looked down at his excited face and smiled. "Yes, it will."